Jesus!
Howdy.
You know what? I'm feeling good today.
Well, that sounds swell. Can't believe my lying eyes.
Anyway, sorry, you don't need to know this.
So long, then.
Arthur! Oh, Arthur!
Now you seem in a good mood.
I am, son. I am. Let's have some fun.
Hey,
tonight. Let's enjoy ourselves.
Are we having a party?
Maybe. Just a little one.
Great.
Even you, Arthur. Even you.
Mr. McGuire is back! So come on!
What?
Let's have ourselves a party!
We're back home now. So everything's going to be okay. Uncle Sean is back. And don't you worry, Miss Grimshaw, y'all crone. I'll keep them girls in line. If I have to whip them, I will.
Did you get a bump on the head?
And don't you worry, Mr. Pearson, you drunk old shitbag. It'll be nothing but the finest game in the pot.
Oh, dead eye mo was back.
And don't worry about nothing, Mrs. Grimshaw.
I love you bastards. Have fun. Have lots of fun.
I'm sure we will.
Can we break down, please? Let's drink. Oh, come on. Let's
enjoy ourselves. Uh-oh, here comes trouble.
I just can't get rid of you, Jenna. Mind if I join you, fine folks?
I suppose.
You're looking lovely.
Still one of life's great pleasures, sitting by the fire with friends. No matter what else happens, nothing quite beats sitting by the fire. You can have the hounds of hell after you and all the angels of vengeance alongside them, but a warm fire and you feel all is okay. Them that discovered the stuff must have thought they was gods among monkeys. They discovered fire. In our time, they've discovered a wire you can talk down to speak to people you wanted to avoid so much you moved.
Finally, some good news, eh?
Well, you usually do, my love. You know this one, don't you? Go chase it. It's a good one.
Can we put the music on?
I will, in a bit.
She says, young man, you're in great shape. I'm gonna go out and get my new one.
A little more civil. Miss O'Shea, dance with me.
Of course, Dutch.
Look at me, with the bell of the ball.
Stop it, you!
Mr. Morgan! Morgan!
Reverend?
Hello!
Hello?
I'm not quite sure. Oh. This keeps happening.
Damn way!
Hey now!
Oh, sorry. Hey there, partner. If you can't treat people with respect, what's the point, I say?
That right.
I've been a tougher place. Do you smoke, sir?
Sure, but perhaps not as much as you.
Oh, no, don't worry about these. Actually, take some. Take a couple of packs. Take a few.
Oh, thank you. What are all the cigarettes for? Are you heading on a long journey or something?
No. Nothing like that at all. I'm just interested in the cards.
Okay.
The cigarette cards. Oh, you got any?
Yeah?
Well, get them out. Let me take a look. Come on.
A little picture card?
Yeah, I'll pay you a good price.
Okay. Here.
Ah, nothing I haven't got. The value is in completing the set. Sometimes I'll smoke up to 200 cigarettes in one day, just so I can keep opening the packs. I wish I could explain to you the pleasure and the pain I get out of collecting these babies.
Sure. Well, it sounds,
thrilling? Yeah, it is. Not to mention the vast amounts of life-reaffirming cigarettes I get to smoke. Oh, and the amount of money? A veritable fortune, sir.
Fortune?
Oh, sure. A complete set of any series is worth a fortune. Yeah, look at this. Gunslingers. Over here, circus freaks. Yes. Meow meows of the desert. So rare.
I never knew.
Sure.
How much?
Well, it depends on the rarity, sir.
Oh, of course.
Yeah. But you know, if you ever get a complete set, I can take it off your hands.
You'd pay me.
A fair price. Now, you send them to me right here. Phineas T. Rams bottle. At your service. I gotta run. This is my train. Look me up, okay? Think about this deal. Only a complete set. That's where the value lies.
Here. You idiot.
Need you now, girl.
Yep.
Shit.
Yes, Miss Grimshaw.
Mr. Matthews gave me a message for you. He said when it was convenient to head into Emerald Ranch. He's looking at a few business things there.
Okay.
Oh, he'll find something, too. He always does. Will you be well now, Mr. Morgan?
I'm always well, Miss Grimshaw.
Hell, and broke my poor knobster. My watch from my fob was picked, sir.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke and I was going off to get married that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again, if you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
Thank you.